कथक। कथक इज अ नॉर्थ इंडियन क्लासिकल डांस फॉर्म। इट टूक इट्स फर्स्ट फॉर्म एंड शेप इन द टेम्पल्स ऑफ स्मॉल विलेजेस लाइक अयोध्या, नाथद्वारा एंड मथुरा इन नॉर्थ इंडिया। इन दीज विलेजेस ट्रेडिशनल स्टोरी टेलर्स वुड नरेट वेरियस स्टोरीज फ्रॉम एपिक्स लाइक रामायण, महाभारत एंड भागवत इन फ्रंट ऑफ ऑल द विलेजर्स एवरी इवनिंग। This act of storytelling would be attended with all the enthusiasm, as it was the only mode of entertainment and was also looked as the means of reaching out to God. These storytellers were called Kathakas. The Kathakas used to add small songs to their stories to make the stories more interesting. These songs would be accompanied by various musical instruments like pakhavaj, flute and the manjiras. With the passage of time, greater vividness was added to this art of storytelling, and eventually it gave rise to a very expressive and versatile dance style called Kathak.
Stop it.
Kathak was named after the people responsible for its origin, the Kathakas. Later on, different genres of Kathak were developed by great artists, which were eventually named after the places they hailed from. They are called gharanas. There are three most prominent gharanas in Kathak: Lucknow, Jaipur, and Banaras gharana. Various Kathak maestros have contributed to the richness of gharanas by adding their own thoughts and their own styles to them. One such name is Srimati Kumudini Lakhia from Ahmedabad, who has given a new face to Kathak, that too being within the limits of tradition. Kumiben, as she is dearly called by friends and disciples alike, is the founder and director of Kadam, an institute imparting training in the field of Kathak dance and choreography. Kumiben learnt Kathak from maestros like Shambhu Maharaji and Sundar Prasadji. After a rigorous taleem for many years, she stepped into the realm of choreography and added a beautiful dimension to Kathak dance. It is indeed a great pleasure to have a tete-a-tete with an artist like Kumudini Lakhia, who is not only a great choreographer, a great dancer, but also a great thinker.
Initially, it was forced on me as a child. I never wanted to dance, but it was forced on me by parents. You know how Maharashtrian parents are, you must either learn music or dance, or in the evening after the school you must go and learn some form of art. So it was sort of forced on me, and it was after many years that I took to Kathak as a kind of full-time practice. By practice I don't mean just practicing the physicality of Kathak, but also the soul of Kathak, the spirit of Kathak, you know, which is so very important. So many students, they practice Kathak and they turn faster, they do louder footwork and more footwork. But what is very important for the students is to feel the pulse of the Kathak dance, to understand the spirit of the Kathak dance, and to get into that. And that is what I was able to do after. And now I feel that I do really understand Kathak, and I really love it now.
For a layperson, the signature of any dance form is the traditional costume that the dancer wears. Kathak has two traditional costumes. One hails from Mughal tradition and the other hails from temple tradition. Now, let's go back to the history of Kathak. Initiated in the temples as a devotional dance, Kathak drifted to the royal courts and finally got established on stage with full vigor and grace as a complete reflection of human life. As a tribute to its origin, Kathak dancers, even today, begin the performance with a vandana or an invocatory dance piece.
Gananath, Namo.